day to you, students. You are welcome to a fresh episode of School on Air Mathematics. Between last time and now, I've missed you, students. A great deal. I'm sure you felt the same way. But not to worry, we are here together again, and we're going to be having a wonderful time together today. Last time, we started trying to solve quadratic equations using the method of completing the square. And then we were cut short by time, and then we stopped only at revising the method of factorization and then looking at what perfect squares are. And then we also saw conditions to determine whether a particular expression is a perfect square. We as well looked at how to know whether a given expression is a perfect square. All right, so today we are looking at how to solve quadratic equations using the method of completing the square. Okay, now when we have quadratic equations whose roots are non-rational numbers, factorization and graphical methods that you have learned before cannot be used. And so does it mean that has to be the end of the quadratic equation? No. There has to be other ways of doing it. And the way around this is the completing the square method. All right, so when we say completing the square, what are we talking about? Completing the square. As the name implies, it specifies what can be added to a non-square rectangle to make it a square. Okay, so that's what we meant by completing the square. If you have a non-square rectangle and you intend to make it a square, so how do you go about it? So that is what completing the square is all about. So now let us try and let's consider a rectangle. We want to see how we can complete a square. Okay, now consider a rectangle whose length is x plus b centimeter. Okay, you have this rectangle with length x plus b centimeter. Okay, from here to here is about x, and then from here to here is b. Okay, and then it has a width of x centimeter. Okay, I'm sure you get what I'm saying now. You have a rectangle f b c and then a prime here being a rectangle, and I said from here to here is x, and then from here to here is b. And of course, the width is x. So if I intend to make this, I intend to complete this a square, because this is a rectangle. The length obviously is longer than the width. So if I intend to make this a square, so what do I do? Now, taking a look at it, our length is x plus b, and then width is x. So if I intend to find the area of that rectangle, that will be what? Of course, you know, when you are doing plane shapes, that your area of a rectangle is what? The length times the width. Okay, so that means I'm having x multiplied by what? X plus b. So if you open up that bracket, we end up with what? X squared plus bx, which is telling us something. It's giving us a quadratic expression. Okay, but since we know that a quadratic expression is usually having three terms, and this is giving us what? Only two, x squared plus, that means something must be added here. There is something that has to be completed. Okay, so let's go back a bit to that diagram. Now, we said we have the length being x plus b, and then we have the width being x. So what do? We divide the b, which is the excess that we have on the length. We divide it by 2, okay? That's why we have b over 2 and b over 2 that we have in there, okay? And then we shift one of those rectangles down here and place it here, okay? So the moment you do that, you realize that the area of this rectangle that we have here will be exactly equal to the area of the new square that we have here. Okay, so that's what we mean when we are saying we are completing the square. So what do we do now? Like I've said there in that diagram, we divide b by 2 and transfer the rectangle ABCD. Where is rectangle ABCD? ABCD. We transfer it to the position A prime, B prime, C prime, and D prime. So where is that position? To the position A prime, B prime, C prime, and then D prime. Okay, so when that is done, then if you take a closer look at the figure, it reveals that A prime FBC has the same area as FADE C prime D prime. What am I saying? We are saying that the area of A prime FBC, let's take a look at it. A prime is A prime FBC, which is the original rectangle, we have about the same area as FADE C prime D prime. FADE C prime D prime, which has completed the square that we have. So that's what we say when we say we are completing the square. Okay? So to complete A prime FBC to a square, what we do is we have our area of B prime DE C prime being equal to B over 2 square. Do you get what I'm saying there? Okay, let's go back to it and take a look at it. Our B prime DE C prime. Our B prime DE C. Okay, since this is a square, the area of this square will be the square of B over 2, since each side is B over 2. So the area will be B over 2. So that area is B over 2 square. So that is added to the original rectangle that we have. Okay, so that gives us x square plus bx plus b over 2 square, which is equal to x plus b over 2 square. Now, having thought about that, let's take a look at the four easy steps to completing the square. I have to go through all of that to make you understand what is the mystery behind completing the square, so that you don't just begin to put the steps in your head. So it doesn't fall from heaven. That is what is done in completing the square. Okay, so what are these four steps? Four easy steps to completing the square. Because I'm sure so many of you, when you are given a quadratic expression to solve, and of course, if it is factorizable, nobody is asking you to use completing the square. The easy way out is to just run through factorization. Okay, but there are instances when questions will specify using the method of completing the square only. And I'm sure most students are always at sea when we come to such situation. Okay, but never to worry. It's a very simple thing. If you follow this routine, you will always be confident completing the square. So what's the first step? You separate the constant term from the variable terms. What are we saying? Suppose we have 4x squared plus 2x plus 3 equals 0. You see, these are variable terms because they are terms containing x. But you have 3 that's a constant term. So the first thing you do is you separate it. So and rearrange such that we now have 4x squared plus 2x is equal to what? Minus 3. Of course, when the 3 goes to the other side, it becomes minus. So minus 3. Okay? And then the second step is if the coefficient, now this one is conditional. If the coefficient of x squared is 1, then you may not need to work with step 2. But if the coefficient is not 1, if coefficient of x squared, I mean to say, if the coefficient of x squared is not equal to 1, then what you do is you divide through by that coefficient. Okay, for instance, in this case, you have your 4x squared plus 2x plus 3. Now, in that situation, the coefficient of x squared there is not 1, it's 4. So what you do next is what? You divide through all the terms by that coefficient of x. So when we did that here, you end up with, of course, your 4x squared divided by 4 will give us x squared, and then what we originally have here was 2x. So when you divide by 4, you end up with what? X over 2. And then the minus 3 that we have here, when we divide by 4, gives us minus 3 over 4. Okay, then step 3. After you have done that, step 3, you add to both sides the square of half the coefficient of x, that like we shown in that diagram. So you have to both sides the square of half the coefficient of x. And in this case, the coefficient of x here now is 1 over 2. Okay, since we have x over 2 here. So the coefficient of x is 1 over 2. Okay, so half of it will be 1 over 4. And then the square of it, that is 1 over 4 squared. So you had that to both sides. So as we had it on the left-hand side, you had it also on the right-hand side. That's why we have this 1 over 4 square here. And then the moment you get to that point, you are home and dry. So what you just do is what? Just factorize what you have on that side. So by factorizing the left-hand side, you end up with what? Your x plus 1 all over 4 squared. And then will be equal to what you have on the right-hand side. And so when you have that, you are just home and dry. The only thing you need to do is just evaluate what you have. Let's go back a bit. You evaluate what you have on the right-hand side here, whatever you get, and then the rest is arithmetic for you to obtain your x. Okay, so let's just look at an example on how to solve quadratic equations using method of completing the square. Now, this one says, solve the following equation using the method of completing the squares. The first one is x squared plus 4 plus x minus 2 equals 0. Then you have b equal 5, saying 5p squared minus 5 equal to 2p. So how do we deal with this? Let's take the first one. First one is saying you have our x squared plus x minus 2 equals 0. So the first step I told us is that you separate the constant term from the variable terms. So what do we do? The constant term here in this case is what? Okay, that's good. That's 2. So your x squared plus x becomes 2 here. If this minus 2 goes to this side, so that will be equal to 2. Okay, and then the next step, we said if the coefficient of x squared is not 1, we divide through by that coefficient. But in this case, the coefficient of x squared is 1. So we may just skip step 2. And then we go to step 3. What does step 3 say? It says that we should add to both sides the square of half the coefficient of x. Okay, so looking at this equation, the coefficient of x is what? 1. So if the coefficient of x is 1, what will be the half of the coefficient of x? Good, 1 over 2. So if it's 1 over 2, then what will be the square? 1 over 2 square. That's correct. So will be equal to, we add that also to what we have on the right-hand side, 1 over 2 squared. Okay, so like I told you at that time, the moment you get to that point, you are home and dry. We just factorize this from your knowledge of factorization that ends up giving us with what this one, x plus 1 over 2 squared being equal to 9 over 4. And if that is the case, if your x plus 1 over 2 squared is equal to 9 over 4, then you can take the square root of both sides. So if you take the square root of both sides, you have your x plus 1 over 2 being equal to plus or minus 3 all over 2. Okay? And then your x will be equal to 3 over 2 plus half, or your x equal minus 3 over 2 minus half. And then you end up with your x equal 1 or your x equal minus 2. Okay? So it's as simple as that. I think we have another one there. We have another one. B. 5p squared minus 5 is equal to 2p. If you have 5p squared minus 5 equal to p, this can be rearranged. This can be rearranged as 5p squared minus 2p equal 5. Okay? So if that is the case, now take a careful look at this one. The coefficient of p squared here is not 1, it's 5. So that means we have to refer back to our step 2, which says that we should divide through by the coefficient of p squared. So if we do that here, that means we have to divide by 5. And then that takes us here. We have p squared minus 2 over 5p being equal to 1. You know how we obtain 1? That's correct. 5 over 5. That gives us 1. So if that is the case, again, we add to both sides the square of half the coefficient of x. Okay? So half the coefficient of x here will be 1 over 5. And then we square it. It's equal to, you do the same thing on the other side. And then when we get to that point, you factorize what you have there to give you p minus 1 over 5 squared being equal to 26 over 5. And then the rest there is just arithmetic. And then you obtain the value for x's. Okay. So if that, I hope that is understood. Yeah, you shouldn't have a problem with it. Just follow the steps. Steps 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then you will always find yourself very comfortable solving quadratic equation using the method of completing the square. Now, so let's go to the fourth method that I told you is an extension of the completing the square. And that one is the one we call the quadratic formula. So many people, they call it the almighty formula because of the complexity of the form of the formula. Okay? But we call it the quadratic formula. So this formula can be deduced. We can deduce this quadratic formula by solving the general form of a quadratic equation using the method of completing the square. So let's take a look at how this is done. Now, you recall that the general form of a quadratic equation is ax squared plus bx plus c equal to 0. Okay, so if we try to separate the constant terms from the variable, like we did before, we end up with what? Ax squared plus bx is equal to what? Minus c. Okay, so what was the next step I told us the other time? Beautiful. So we divide through by the coefficient of x squared. So in this case, the coefficient of x squared is what? Is a. So we end up with what? X squared plus bx over a is equal to minus c over a. And then we add to both sides. Just follow the routine. Add to both sides the square of half the coefficient of x. And when that happens, we end up with what? X squared plus bx over a plus, of course, remember, the coefficient of x here now is b over a. So the half is b over 2a, then squared. And then you do the same thing on the right-hand side. And then by the time we factorize what we have here, we end up with what? X plus b over 2a all squared being equal to minus c over a plus b squared over 2a. Okay, so we have my x plus b over 2a squared being equal to this. And then if we try to simplify this, we end up having b squared minus 4ac. If you open up this and then you try to do some arithmetic there, you find your b squared minus 4ac over 4a squared. So if my x plus b over 2a now is equal to, you know, we are taking square root of both sides now. Since we have a square here and we didn't have a square here, okay, and then we are trying to obtain a value for x. So we take square root of both sides and then that leaves us here. Okay, and then the rest is just arithmetic. Then you have your x being equal to minus b plus or minus the root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. So that is how we use the method of completing the square to obtain the quadratic formula, the one that is referred to as the almighty formula. I hope that is understood. So far on today's episode, we have been able to discuss the need for completing the square method in quadratic equation. I told us you may have problems solving some equations if you are addicted to only factorization and graphical method. And then we also talked about the steps involved in completing the squares. I told us the first thing, you separate the constant term, the next thing is divide through by the coefficient of x squared, and then the next step is you have to both sides the square of half the coefficient of x, and then of course the rest is done. Okay, and then I think that's all we have talked about today. So I would just want to leave you with some of these exercises to lay your hands on, and please make sure you use the method of completing the square alone to solve this. So anyway, you can use method of completing the square and as well use the quadratic formula, but don't try using the graphical method or the factorization method. Okay, so here are the questions that you are going to be laying your hands on. The first one, you have x squared plus 6x plus 8 equals 0. You have 3x squared equals x plus 5. And of course, you have 2 into x squared minus 4 plus 6x equals 0. You also have x over 3 minus 6 over x plus 5 over 3 is equal to 0. Now, looking at those questions, some of them might look very tricky to you, but not to worry. Just deal with those fractions accordingly, and then you will have the general form of the quadratic equation. Okay, I wish you a splendid time even as you lay your hand on these exercises, and then I'll be looking forward to meeting you again on another episode. Bye for now.